Hi everyone, we are at the airport and this is Cloudy and her little expandable carrier. We're about to check in right now, so I will let you know how it goes. Okay, so we just got through security and I'm wearing my mask. Hopefully you can hear everything that I'm saying, but security with a pet was honestly no different than if I didn't have a pet. They didn't ask me for her health certificates or anything, and my ticket just says pet. I just have her here. I'm gonna flip the camera around so I can show you guys. She's in her little carrier. So this is Cloudy in her little airline carrier. As you can see, it expands on both sides. And so she looks kind of chilling. And you know, we'll see how it goes. Bye. So now you can't do the emotional support animal thing, which was helpful not just because the fee was waived, but also because the size of the animal didn't really matter. Now I'm flying on Frontier and I'm gonna do, Cloudy's flying with me as an in-cabin pet. That means that they have to be able to fit in an airline approved carrier and sit at the bottom of the seat. So that's why I got the expandable one. As far as health certificates, I thought that I needed something called a certificate of veterinary inspection, which is a really official form, and it can only be filled out by like a board certified veterinarian. And in my state, Pennsylvania, there aren't even that many board certified veterinarians. So anyway, I ended up reading the fine print. It depends on your destination state, but the certificate of veterinary inspection for Florida is not required when it's a privately owned animal that's traveling with its owner. When I read that, I was so happy. All I have are her health forms and her proof of rabies vaccination and the carrier, and that's it. I did bring her little water bottle, just travel water bottle. I did give her a chew stick, and she seems really content, you guys. Check her out.